Okay,
thank you so much.
Thank you so much for the headlines.
Mm. All right, well, the All Africa Games still definitely mm-hmm. taking the front burner mm-hmm. At this point in time. Mm-hmm. You were talking about Martin Adomeit, Austin, mm-hmm. who is now in the fray, the technical advisor for the Nigerian contingent to the All Africa Games. I listened to what he said earlier in the day while taking on the news, and you know, he made some really valid points. You know, you're talking about Nigeria, yes. The quality is there, mm-hmm. the skill is there, but mm-hmm. you know, a little bit of exposure.
That's it.
You know, trying to make the players believe in themselves that they can achieve, you know, greatness, and that for him is the most important thing. You know,
totally.
Trying to get our players play top, you know, class
competitions. Table tennis.
You know, in different parts of the continent and of course around the world.
When I spoke to the former German national coach, I wanted to find out what he could differently in 2 weeks, you know, before the games. And he says, when you're dealing with professionals, you're dealing with players that have quality, you don't need to do much. Just play with them up here. Mm-hmm. Just play with the psychology. Just push them. You just tell them one or two things. And I spoke to some of the players. They said, when you're using the backhand, it comes to you and tell you, maybe try this, or this other.
You're not teaching them the basics.
You know, because these are professionals.
They're professionals.
So what he's doing is, go there and let these players believe that they have a guide in Congo. You know, when you're not doing well, you can turn back and see your coach, which has always been a problem for Arena Quadra and some other players when they go out, nobody to talk to them. Mm-hmm. You know, I told you when I was in Yaoundé, when Arena Quadra was playing Omar Asar, all the Chinese coach was doing was watch Quadri's movements. Mm-hmm. He just kept on looking at his feet to see the way he's moving. And that was all he said to Omar Asar, and Omar Asar was able to return every game.
How to make the transition between being a good table tennis player and being excellent. And being world class is what they just said. They're just paying attention to those little details here and here, and that's I guess why that's why Adomeit is saying that. Look, these guys are good. These guys are professionals. Just I'll pay attention to those little details. Mm-hmm. I'll serve it to them on the plates. They'll use it, and they'll be on top. Because really, you want to wonder what can really be done in two weeks. But if you can work with the cream, the best. Mm. Of our players who are already on top in Africa anyway,
exactly.
Then you know we might just.
I'm sure they're always willing to learn new
push off the Egyptians,
new styles, and all
I
of that.
I keep saying, give me Barcelona, I'll manage Barcelona. Channels TV. Remember, you can be part of the fun. Let's just quickly bring you into the things. We love it when you're involved. On Twitter, @channels_sports, and on Facebook, @channels_sports. We want you to join the discussion this morning for the hashtag IWF World Championships. We're also taking a look at league development in Nigeria. We'll talk about the Super Eagles. And, of course, we will talk about the Afro Basket Championship. Nigeria gets ready to take on Mozambique. I and Cecilia actually prayed for that. That's come to pass. Okay, we're just really speaking about table tennis in Nigeria. Let's listen to the new German tactician who will be taking Nigeria to the African Games. His name is Martin Adomeit. He says Nigeria has the quality to impress the players. They say they are ready to conquer Africa. We'll be right back.
I think I have experience and I look from outside. So you have some other viewing for the players, and so perhaps I can help.
Tell me, does Nigeria have quality in table tennis?
The quality is good. Yeah, we know how the quality in Africa, but we know too that Arona Quadri, he plays really good. He's one of the best players in the world. We have really good quality, but I think you can develop. Because you can have more success with this technique and this physical, must be possible to have more success in table tennis. It's one thing is to believe at themselves. That's one really important thing. Every player is very often discussing over things what he cannot do. But it's not necessary that you can all. You need stronger side, you need weapons, and you must believe yourself. If you believe every point, then you can beat a lot of players. For sure, we have some small instructions for techniques to develop, but you cannot develop in 2 weeks a lot. And the other thing is for me, for Nigerian table tennis, and that is what I saw the last 20 years, you can develop a lot in tactical things. because the technique is really good, the physical is normally really good, but in technical things you can be better. But that goes fast. If you work a little bit with the head, it's possibilities to reach fairly, really fast, more success than now. For sure you need experience in competitions. That's the other things, and that is not so easy for players from Africa to get really enough experience in competitions international. Yeah?
We having him around is going to create a lot of impact because he knows what to do, he's experienced, and he's going to do it. And even the Egyptian, mere seeing him around, I know they will be shaking also because they know that we are well prepared for them.
Having Mr. Adomeit around will make a lot of differences. I think he can do it alone, just like he said earlier. We believe in all the coaches and not just only him. But having him around here with the other coaching crew will seriously make a lot of differences. We believe that with this coaching team, we will surpass our previous performance in the games.
The Congolese, you know, they've been like in China for like a year. I think the Egyptian too, they went to China. The Cameroonian too, they are training hard. But one thing I know for sure, like I keep telling people, Nigerian they carry last. Though we've been training here in Nigeria, but we have good coaches that they've been giving all their best, you know. Like, it's been a long time that I've seen Nigerian hungry. You know, the guys, the girls, the coaches, everybody is hungry, you know. And you know why? Because Egyptians have taken the glory from us for a very long time, and it is high time that we're going to take everything that they've taken from us back.
Okay, that's it. Experienced table tennis longevity player Olufunke Oshonaike. She said one thing that she knows, she keeps telling you guys, the Nigerians, they carry last.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We hope so. We hope results at the All African Games
will show that.
Olufunke just becomes the latest, you know, to join the list of players and coaches are saying they will win at the All Africa Games.
And then we're talking about the Egyptians, you know, yeah, having stage fright the moment they see, the team with Martin Adomeit.
Also,
you know,
that's psychology.
And the list is quite long now. We can begin to count a lot of associations that have promised us medals.
I said Fouquet.
And I'm writing their names.
So
their names down.
The game, Jose, you said you. This.
You were going to give us seven.
Seven.
Nigeria Taekwondo, George Ashiru. That assurance,
the boxers, as
the
well.
Boxers, wrestling, Danny Gali.
Mm-hmm. All right,
we have you all right here. That's
so,
it.
So, we hope for the best. Definitely, we do hope for the best. All right, so let's check out what the papers, the sports papers, are indeed saying right now. And we're now joined in the studio by our guest, talking about Chinasia Iboyin, who is a sports analyst for the Sports Paper Review. Nice to have you this morning.
I'm very well, thank you, Ayotunde.
All right.
And Yemi, how you guys doing?
Yeah. We're good.
It sounds like a sausage fest. Cecilia is not around today. Okay.
Anyway, so what's been the major talking points for you? What's got you talking?
Well, of course, the All Africa Games, the IWF World Championships. Uh-huh. Blessing Okabari unfortunately couldn't get a medal.
Great. Not talking about that.
No. I will talk about that.
I think she
did quite well getting to the finals. Mm-hmm. It means she's among the top eight women in the world. I'm talking about fastest women.
Yeah.
And you know, it's just a matter of margins. Sometimes you have to condition yourself to peak at the right time. We saw it in 100 meters male when Justin Gatlin ran a better time in the semifinals and didn't get to run that time in the finals. The same thing happened with Blessing Okabare. She was faster in the semifinals. She ran a 10.89, and in the final she ran an 11 seconds. So it shows it's all about conditioning, and maybe the lane she was placed in. You know, lane 9. The fact that she wasn't.
She wasn't
in the mix with the likes of Shelly Ann Fraser Price. If you had seen the semi-final race where she was with Shelly Ann Fraser,
and you could measure.
Yeah, it pushed her.
Both sides.
Where she was, she couldn't really measure. You know, she couldn't be pushed by the other girl. So it was a couple of things here and there. She's beaten Shelly Ann Fraser Price before, so it's not like we don't know her quality. It's just that, you know.
Chinasa, let me quickly throw this at you. You know, is it of any consolation that there are. Ivorian rival
Moriel Aure, didn't even make it to the final.
It's not any consolation. I don't think Blessing should be
consoled by that.
Know, should be consoled by the fact that Moriel Aure, who was silver medalist at the last championship, did not get to.
Who also has a personal best that's almost the same.
You know,
as
Blessing. It just shows you that it's very competitive
in the
women's 100 meters. Anybody can beat anybody. Mm. The girl that took second, the ice keepers, she used to do the heptathlon about 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
nobody saw that coming.
The heptathlon. Yeah. She was doing 7 events until she finally decided to focus on the 100 meters.
Do you know what, guys? We'll just keep quiet. I want us to watch this race again. It will play again, and then we'll try to understand what went wrong with Blessing Akagbari. We'll be back.